Hey everyone, Happy New Year. Let's see who's going to go next. Oh, that was kind of a sorry spin. Sorry. That was Pisces. Pisces already went anyway. Who is this? Gemini. Gemini will be going. Okay. Gemini. Sun, Moon, Rising. Happy New Year, guys. And I hope you guys had a great holiday. I really, really tried to do the readings for you guys in December, but it was just too much. I had to catch up on work before I went on vacation, and it was just impossible for me. So my apologies. And then I really had to spend time with my family. I wanted to take that time. I was looking forward to it. So I'm sorry for not being able to get the readings done, but here I am. So I'm going to do the 5-card spread that I do that covers 5 different areas of your life. And then in the mid-month, I'll do the whole story reading. So let's begin. Again, this is for the sign of the Gemini. Okay, so the first position is going to be your mind, body, soul. Let's see in what state you are in or what the theme will be for 2024. Okay, we have the Empress reverse. Next card is romance, love and romance. We have the 4 of Pentacles. Next card is finances and career. We have the Magician in reverse. Next is friendships and social circles. Actually, I got 2 cards. I don't want that. Friendships and social circles. What does Gemini need to know? With the Lovers reverse. And finally, we have family. And you have the Wheel of Fortune. Okay, at the bottom we have 7 of Pentacles. Okay. Let's start off with this Empress. Empress reverse. Some of you could be feeling kind of depleted. Guilt. I release any beliefs that no longer assist in my soul's growth. Honesty. I can't always expect the truth from others, but I can expect it from myself. And abundance. I am a limitless being, and I can manifest whatever I desire in this physical reality. So the Empress is very abundant, typically, but being here in the reverse, you may not be feeling very abundant at this time. We do have success at the bottom, but you can turn that around at any point. I feel like the reason that you're not feeling this way is because of this guilt. There's some guilt that you're feeling here. Why? interesting. We have the Seven of Swords here. And then we have that Honesty card. So what happened? And then we have the Nine of Cups. So was there some overindulgence that happened? Seven of Cups. Eight of Wands. Knight of Cups reverse. Empress reverse. Again, repeat card. The Devil. Do one more. The Four of Wands. Okay. Yeah, at the bottom we have the Three of Pentacles. I feel like some of you, like, this is going outside of a relationship because we do have the Four of Wands here. So I get the feeling like this is broken promises. Somebody got caught up in temptation. I'll just leave it at that. It doesn't have to be stepping out of a relationship, although the Empress in reverse, sometimes I do see her as a mistress. So you could have been a mistress, or someone had a mistress, or something like that, especially with that Knight of Cups being there reverse. But it doesn't have to be that particular theme. I just feel like there were some broken promises here. And with the Seven of Cups and the Devil, somebody fell into temptation and is feeling guilt about that. And that's why not feeling as abundant or as great as, you know, normally would, because you weren't as honest as you could have been. Okay, so we'll leave that there. The Four of Pentacles. So yeah, look at the depiction. It looks like a lesbian couple. So this deck is called the Modern Love Tarot. And it's all types of couples. So it could be same-sex couples, all types of couples. And so this couple happens to be same-sex couple. She's standing behind the girl, and it looks like she's kind of spying, looking to see who she's texting or whatever on her phone, very suspiciously. And this is the romance and relationship card, or position. So, and it's the Four of Pentacles. So this is kind of being guarded. She is sort of suspicious. Why? Why is she suspicious? Let's see. Courage. I find the inner strength to face fear with confidence. Purpose. I know what I am here to do. And humor. I choose to focus on the lighter side of life. Whoops. At the bottom, we have loneliness. Okay, let's see. Eight of Pentacles. Queen of Wands reverse. There's that Seven of Swords. Seven of Swords reverse. 8 years could be of relevance to some of you. You could have been with someone for 8 years. Someone was juggling. Two of Pentacles. The Chariot. Chariot reverse. Yeah, I feel like somebody lost control of a situation. It came to a screeching halt. And it was because of someone's insecurities. Now we have someone was juggling. Someone was a player. I feel like this stems from, look, Nine of Swords. Yeah. And the King of Swords. There was somebody here who's deeply insecure, and I feel like this made them actually act out. So this was a situation where the person who was actually, here's the thing. I feel like this person, the one who was suspicious, was actually the one cheating. Because they were the fearful one. They were the one who was afraid to get cheated on. And so they self-sabotaged. Like they were so afraid that they went and did it first so that they wouldn't be the one to get hurt. You know, at least that's how I'm feeling it. But the whole thing was sabotaged. Which sucks because there was so much put into it. Like it was already a structured relationship. Like you probably lived together. You probably were together for a while. Like I said, for some of you, 8 years or more. But someone started spying, and that's another thing. Like somebody may have started being very suspicious. So, okay. So in one scenario, what I just said may have been the case. So the person who was more suspicious was the one doing the cheating. In another case, because of the fact that one person was so suspicious, and I'm not trying to give the person an excuse, but it kind of drove. So this person was suspicious of this person. And because of that, it drove this person to cheat. Like this person said, well, they're accusing me anyway. I might as well. You know what I mean? Not to give them an excuse, but that's kind of how it went. So it's one of those things where in order to have a relationship, somebody needs to work on allowing for things to just flow rather than being so uptight about things or taking things so seriously, like just letting people live their lives, you know, and instead of being like a parole officer to a partner, because who wants that? So someone is just living off of fear instead of just living life and dragging somebody into that fear state of mind, because nobody wants that. So that was the demise of that relationship. That's what I see. Finances and career, we have the Magician in reverse. Something that you want to create is just not, you're having trouble executing it. It's not happening for you. Grief, I understand that losing something is an opportunity to appreciate it. Death, I am learning that endings are merely beginnings. Discipline, I can accomplish what I set my mind to. All right, so some of you may have lost a job, and you may be in search of one, and it might take some patience. Let's take a look. It's not the best economy, you know, to be in that position. So yeah, patience is going to be needed. But oh, look what peaked. And then we have the Emperor is also peaking here. So, ooh, nice, nice, nice. Okay, let's see. Nine of Pentacles, okay. Ooh, Ten of Cups. I'm not taking two at a time. That was a Magician reverse again, though. Six of Pentacles reverse. Hierophant reverse. Mm-hmm. Okay. So there's some type of like instability, obviously. There's instability in a workplace, in an organization. So some of you were making good money, you were happy in a place where you were working, and then all of a sudden the rug was pulled from under you. Yeah, and now you feel like, all right, let's see, like you have nothing, like, you know, everything's up in the air. Let's see. Okay, so going forward, we have the Fool. Four of Pentacles, okay. Right, nice. Here's the thing. So I do feel like you're going to find something new. But the thing is, where you land, it's like you have to start over. You have to rebuild from there. The Four of Pentacles. But it is going to, you're going to find stability again. Is it going to be the same as where you came from? This it was like where you came from, you were a big fish in a little pond. And so there was this feeling like this big comfort zone. Okay. You came from your comfort zone. Your comfort zone is not necessarily the best place to come from. Okay. There is a need to move out of that comfort zone. And so, yeah, you're moving out of that. You were happy there. I understand it. Which is why you're feeling this grief in this death process. But Ten of Pentacles reverse, you're going to feel, you may not be making the same amount of money, which is, you know, we're kind of seeing why the sense of like needing to rebuild. You may feel like you have to cut corners a little bit or change your lifestyle, but is it going to be a stable position? Yes. What I do see here, though, you're coming out of, we have the Five of Pentacles, but it is in the reverse. So this is coming out of financial difficulty. So you're not going to be, if you are in financial difficulty right now, you're not going to be in financial difficulty for very long. You are going to come out of that. And what I do see here that's good and that's interesting is the King of Cups with the Seven of Cups. So there seems to be a lot of opportunity here for you to expand on your creativity. So it seems like you're going to be learning a lot of new things, or there's a lot of opportunity for you to broaden your horizons. So it's really where you want to take this. This is really about expansion. If you had stayed where you were, yeah, it's really comfortable and all, but there's no growth there. So is this going to take discipline? Yeah, it's going to take discipline because there's growth here. I think that's a better plan. That's a better route because you have to evolve at some point. And there's a little pain there in evolution, but it's necessary. So take that as it may. All right. The Lovers in reverse. This is in your friends and social circle sector. This is your energy, Gemini. Lovers in reverse. Let's see. Fear. I realize that I am testing my resolve to live in the energy of love. What happened here? You had a bad experience or something? Judgment. Yeah. I understand that the letters are a little dark. That everyone has their own unique path and challenges. Blame. I accept responsibility for my well-being. Yeah, something definitely happened here with your friends or a friend in particular. Maybe you had to let go, or you will be like letting go of a friend or friends. Hierophant reverse. Could be dealing with a Taurus. Yeah. Eight of Cups. You're walking away from... There's a... somebody switched up on you. The Tower. Like you feel like you don't, there's someone here that you don't recognize anymore. Like they're totally different. They're not who they used to be. Their whole character has changed, and maybe you just don't resonate with them anymore. And you have no choice but to walk away. Seven of Cups, you're highly confused by this. You're confused by their behavior, the things that they say. Seven of Wands, reverse. You're tired of the constant bickering, or you kind of feel like they're against you. You don't like feeling that way. The way that they speak to you, you feel like you're talking to an enemy. Yeah, it's something about the communication between the two of you. It's combative. And so that's why you feel like you just don't vibe anymore. Something switched up, something changed. You can't quite put your finger on it. Like, it's not something you can easily identify to be able to sit down and say, hey, you did this and this and this, let's fix it. It's just an array of things that are almost unidentifiable. So how do you really work on something that's, whoa, I don't like how that came up. Do one more. Yeah, it's like you kind of see this person as very immature now. Maybe they're going through some kind of, I don't know how old you are, but some type of like midlife crisis or, you don't relate to them. That's all. That's what I'm seeing. You don't relate to them anymore. For some of you don't agree with what they're doing in their relationships. Yeah, there's something here about relationships. They could be cheating on their partners. There's something about their character that you're not on the same page with, and so yeah. I'll leave it at that. You're not, you don't align on many levels. You just don't align with them. Okay. Family, Wheel of Fortune, a lot of changes. New cycle for your family. Let's see what this is about. Acceptance. I'm learning to accept the things that I cannot change. Yeah, the Wheel of Fortune is definitely something that is destined. We cannot change that. Balance. I bring a state of perfect harmony into my world, and I do so without judgment. Interesting. Friendship. I understand that a friend is in my life for a reason. Chariot reverse. Strength. The devil reverse. Page of Cups. And the King of Cups. Do one more. And the Ace of Pentacles. Yeah, so there's definitely a new beginning here. We have Cancerian energy pretty strong with the moon, the chariot, and even that King of Cups there. So somehow this friendship thing may be tying in with the family. So I don't know if perhaps this friendship, you know, was so close that it was like family. Whatever the case is, this whoever that was not a good influence on your family. Something had to go. Someone had to go. Because they were causing some chaos. They were not of, they had ill will against your family. And so I feel like it took courage it took a lot of personal strength on your part to make that choice, to choose your family's overall well-being and cut off, you know, any kind of relationship that was holding you back, was holding your family back from thriving. I feel like you did what was best for your family. Yeah, there's definitely, you hold guilt here for allowing someone to interfere in a family dynamic. And now you're having to start over. So there's a lot of emotions that you're holding inside. You don't necessarily express them to your family, to the people that you love most. You know that there were a lot of failures, a lot of setbacks. But you very consciously let those things go. And this year you want, it's like you're turning over a new leaf and you want to do right by them. You want to do better. But these emotions, there's definitely healing that needs to happen on your part to not hold all that within you, because it takes a lot of self-awareness to do this, to let go of all this. You know, not everybody does that. Not everyone puts their family as a priority and lets go of negative attachments. Not everyone does that. So give yourself those props that at least you put your family first. All right, let's see. Final messages for Gemini. We have the Lovers again, your energy. There are two paths ahead. Be true to yourself. Phoenix, be prepared to be renewed after a period of crisis. Yeah, so the worst is over. Now you just have to focus on renewing yourself, healing. Celebrations, you are ready to bring in new and exciting things into your life. Yeah, so focus on that. And goals, progress. Progress is positive and personal goals will be achieved. Okay, so a lot to look forward to, Gemini. Focus on that. I'll see you guys soon.